Welcome back to this already, the final segment of The Price of Business. I am your host, Kevin Price, talking to you about you and your business. I want to remind you, of course, the best content here shows up over there at usdailyreview.com, where today you can find an article about Steve Stockman. Thanks to our friends over at Human Events, we've reprinted it over there. And Steve Stockman is a good friend of mine, a great friend of the show, and we both go back longer now than either one of us want to admit. And he is a congressman from here in the Houston area and aspires to be the next U.S. senator. And I'm delighted to have you on the show.
Yeah, well, it's great being here.
So,
how are you?
I'm awesome. Where is here right now? Where are you at these days or this moment?
I am actually I just got handed a bill that we're working on, and I'm actually up in Washington D.C. So, as always, it's been a busy day, but we appreciate you taking the time and taking our call.
Oh, of course, of course. So, tell us a little bit about, you know, I got to tell you, for months, in fact, my producer Sigmund Kramer and I, we've been talking on and on for ages that somebody had to run against the liberal John Cornyn. Someone needed to run against the liberal John Cornyn. And I was getting, you know, and there's this, you know, discussion about Gohmert running, and there's, you know, now there's a handful of people that have no political experience whatsoever. And I'm going, we need someone who can run, who has electoral success, who knows how to win an election, and knows how to do it with a mean and lean budget. And I mean, you're like the poster child of that, Steve.
Thanks. I appreciate it. I actually talked to Louis Gohmert about that and said, you know, you need to do it, and tried to pressure him, and he didn't want to do it. And there were others that called me and said, you need to do it. I had one friend in Austin who was calling me quite frequently asking me to do it. I'm giving up my seat, and it's really a high risk operation. So it took a lot of consideration before we decided to do it.
Yeah, and you were required to give up your seat in order to do it?
Yeah.
Okay. So the Johnson Law doesn't apply for running for two in state offices?
No, that Johnson rule was only if you were running for president or vice president. It was made for Lyndon Baines Johnson.
Custom made. It was custom made.
Yes, it was.
It must be nice to have custom made laws, man. That's pretty sweet. Man, oh, man. So that was a pretty huge decision.
Yeah. It was very, very challenging in terms of making that decision because, you know, we could have stayed here till I was 90. I mean, it's a very conservative district. And our numbers in that district were rather high, like
yeah,
80%.
Yeah, overall, well, like 75% is what you won the seat by, so it's pretty ridiculous. Yeah, even with Libertarian in that mix.
Yeah,
and that was your first year in that particular district, so it's pretty extraordinary. Well, but I'm proud of you, dude. You know, you're going to look back historically, and I think you're going to look at this as a great decision. And to me, it's a great way. All of you people out there who are bellyaching over how liberal the Republican Party has become, stop bellyaching and do something. This party desperately needs discipline, and a vote for Steve Stockman can restore discipline in a conservative direction.
I appreciate that. And again, I'd like to point out, if you recall, John Cornyn, while Ted Cruz was single-handedly trying to stop Obamacare, and some of the comments were Obamacare is not that bad, and really, really ridiculed him for that. Well, it turns out now Ted Cruz was right and John Cornyn was wrong. And he really, if he had a disagreement, he should have probably done it privately instead of been so public about dressing down Ted Cruz and saying that what he was doing was foolish.
Well, obviously Mitch McConnell is more important to him than Ted Cruz.
Yeah, and I'm frustrated that you know, if you're in a foxhole, you want the guy shooting at the other guy across. You know, instead it seems he was more apt to work with Harry Reid than he was with Ted Cruz.
Yeah, I agree with that. I absolutely agree with that. So, you know, looking at what's happening out there, you know, kind of give us a macro overview of your strategy.
Well, this is a well. First of all, I won't say everything, obviously, but
no, I want detail. I want detail right now.
Yeah. I actually had a reporter call me from Breitbart. I said, "Dude, are you working for John Cornyn?" Because he was asking me. He goes, "Well, what's your strategy? What's this? What's that?" I said,
yeah.
"You know what?
Keep it broad. Keep it broad until we go out to lunch. Keep it broad."
Yeah, he goes to me. Anyhow, going on, we're going to be very aggressive. We're going to be grassroots, and same similar thing we did when we ran for Congress. We're going to have use social media and things like that that will expand upon our base. And I think our base is most people that are supporting Ted Cruz would support me. We just got to get the message out to those that support Ted Cruz. Now, if you don't support Ted Cruz, then you either aren't voting in the Republican primary or you're not really a conservative.
That's right. I agree with that entirely. And I would go so far to say that, you know, that Cornyn essentially supports Obamacare. I've been saying
yeah.
that. You know, it's so easy to be opposed to this thing. And you got to be opposed at every single opportunity. And he's chosen at least one. I want to find out more. But he's chosen at least one opportunity to not say no to Obamacare. And so shame on him.
Well, we actually have a letter from John Cornyn where it states in 2009 that he thought Obamacare is going to be a good thing and that they should pass it so it helps with the 2010 elections.
Wow.
Which is kind of like drilling a hole in your boat and saying that by sinking the boat, it'll make it better for the world. I mean, it's not logical and the rationale behind it.
Yeah, absolutely. No question about it. Talking to Steve Stockman, congressman here from the Houston area, aspiring for the office of U.S. Senate. When did you make the decision to run?
Well, when Louis decided not to do it, we decided to take a closer look at it. And it was a process of determining whether it was a viable option. And we did determine it was a viable option and that we could go forward in a way that, you know, would communicate with everybody. So it was not like, you know, one day we woke up, hey, you think we're going to run for Senate? So it was, you know, it was a gradual thing. And then we worked on strategy and things like that. So it was last minute, but it was because we had to take this decision very seriously.
Yeah, absolutely. It took quite a while. I thought the timing was awesome. I just couldn't believe it. I was sitting at home. I'm shocked you didn't call me. Thanks a lot just to let me know. But I was sitting there watching the news at 10:15 and on Monday night, and then there it was, Steve Stockman's running for U.S. Senate. I was like, what? It's like, that was incredible. So that was an early Christmas present and very excited about it. And so I think it's a great opportunity for us and looking forward to see how this goes. Any thoughts or comments before I let you go?
No, I would ask your listeners to forward the Stockman for 2014 website to anybody that can and also visit that page. We're only about 7 million short of what John Cornyn has.
Yeah, well, this too will change, you know, and what you can do with people is extraordinary, and we'll see that as we go along. And again, as Stockman 2000, is it Stockman2014.com, right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, Stockman2014.com. Make sure you check that out. Steve Stockman running for U.S. Senate. We'll be hearing more from him in the weeks to come. Thanks for being with us.
No problem, Kevin, and thank you for taking my call.
You bet. All right. When we come back tomorrow, of course, we're going to have much, much more for you. But in the next 23 hours, make sure you spend some time over there at our sister news website, usdailyreview.com. While there, like it on Facebook, follow it on Twitter, and this is The Price of Business.